Since the start of the year, 1,225 free games have been released on the Android alone. Now that we're pretty much halfway through, we bring you the list of the top 15 free Android games of 2020 so far, arranged by PlayScore. You can find the complete list on our website, whattoplay.com, link on the description box below. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe, and don't forget to hit that notification bell. We're starting number 15 with Missile Command Recharged. A strong start to our free games list, Atari returns to the scene this year with a revival of one of their beloved classic arcade titles. Made for the new generation of platforms, this iteration of the Missile Command title forgoes the bulky pixels of the bygone video game era for the smooth HD graphics of today. Even so, it still has the markings of the original game. Pick up from where you last left off and dive once more into the arcade addiction. It has a play score of a 7.37.
Time to disappear!
14th on our list is Shadowgun Wargames Online PvP FPS. With this new game's arrival on the Android, Madfinger Games has received the same warm welcome for yet another futuristic shooter. Focusing on co-op multiplayer gameplay, Wargames plays on the 5v5 formula, covering the usual lineup of tanks, supports, and damage dealers.
Fire in the hole.
While it only has 5 characters, they each have unique skills that bring something new to the table. Plus, you get to customize them with skins, emotes, and so much more. Madfinger Games has always been known for their clean, polished visuals, and they brought that same energy to this title. A portable and free shooter, it receives a play score of a 7.39. At lucky number 13 is Dragon Quest of the Stars. A star-studded production made especially for the mobile, Square Enix presents something on the mobile that united the powers of Dragon Quest's own Yuji Horii and Koichi Sugiyama for direction and music, as well as Dragon Ball's Akira Toriyama for character design. From the looks of things, it's a pretty high-quality title, and the fact that the game is free makes it a little unbelievable. On the other hand, it does have a fair bit of flaws. As in most mobile games, it has some pay-to-win elements, with overpowered items that widen the gap between players and rare gems and those without. But for a price of absolutely nothing, it offers a pretty expansive open-world experience that earns a play score of a 7.45. Twelfth place is Game of Thrones Beyond the Wall. Thanks to Behavior Interactive, fans of the HBO series may finally have something to hold on to. A turn-based strategy, it challenges you to take command of the Night's Watch and defend the wall with an optimized squad. As a video game tie-in, it even features some of our favorite heroes from the series to fight with us side by side in a war of fire and ice. It may not be as spectacular as the iconic battles that we've had the pleasure of witnessing through the years, but it does come with a fun gameplay and a unique story that fans will definitely enjoy. It has a play score of a 7.51. 11th place is Disney Sorcerer's Arena. Going with Disney's more traditional licenses, Sorcerer's Arena lets you engage in a turn-based RPG goodness using the legendary heroes of our collective cartoon childhood. From their 2D classics like Mickey Mouse and The Little Mermaid, to the 3D favorites like Sully and Buzz Lightyear. Also featuring a real-time PvP, use these heroes to show off your skills and compete against other people from around the globe. Some of the items may be a bit pricey though, as most Disney things are, so you should better watch out for any in-app purchases. It has a play score of a 7.65. At number 10 is Magic Mana Strike. Strategy games have definitely hit it big on the mobile this year. Instead of the usual turn-based titles, this new game from Netmarble deals with the action of real-time combat. Following the formula of Supercell's Clash Royale and using characters from Magic the Gathering, it focuses on the power of spells and sorcery to create exciting and strategic battles. Because it's based on a card game, its card game mechanics seem a lot deeper than the usual fare. And with the vast universe of its source material, there's a lot of vibrance in its presentation too. Something for the fans of Clash Royale and Magic the Gathering, it gets a play score of a 7.81. Ninth on our list is Kartrider Rush Plus. While Kartrider Drift is already lined up for the PC and console sometime soon, Nexon Games gives us a taste in this portable version. At first glance, the game looks mattifying with its lively environments populated by a lineup of adorable racers. In their various game modes, race clean in the speed race, strategically use items in the classic item race, or zoom through their single-player story mode. Kart racers have always been a multiplayer extravaganza though, and that's definitely this game's biggest draw. If you're careful against those pricey cars, you might enjoy this free racer with a score of an 8.01. Did you know that your reviews can influence the play score? Register now at whattoplay.com and start reviewing games. Link on the description box below. Moving on to number 8 with Cryptract. Though it has only been localized on the Android this year, Cryptract has actually been at it for years now, mainly as a Japanese mobile game and as a port to the PlayStation 4. It may offer less in terms of the wow factor, but it does balance it all out with a fantastic never-ending storyline, a decent amount of content, and a pretty balanced gacha system. All that combined makes it feel like a more premium experience than the previous games. Take your pick from the selection of characters and watch them evolve into even more powerful players in the long game of strategy. Still a neat free-to-play JRPG, it gets a score of an 8.04. At number 7 is MIB Galaxy Defenders Free 3D Alien Gun Shooter. As far as mobile games go, this Sony Pictures tie-in is a pretty straightforward on-rail shooter that's reminiscent of the arcade games we used to love. In every stage, you'll find a few worthy aliens to blast. So take your aim with whatever gun the stage requires, and in barely a minute, you'll be ready for the next one. The levels may be a little too easy, and precise aim just a little bit challenging. It's an exciting way to spend a few minutes nonetheless, especially with a few bonus challenges to achieve. Nailing everything from gameplay to graphics, it gets a score of an 8.04. Sixth on our list is Teamfight Tactics League of Legends strategy game. The auto battler genre may have had its origins on Valve's Dota 2, but that hasn't stopped the makers of one of the widest played MOBA to cash in on it too. By bringing the high production experience of the PC title to the portable format, Riot effectively reels their high player numbers into a brand new game. The interface and the balance may seemingly have a lot of room for improvement, but compared to the many auto chess clones out there, this is a huge upgrade. Providing a high-quality avenue for fans of the strategy phenomenon, it gets a play score of an 8.04. We're down to number 5 with Hidden Survivor. Even in the realm of free games, it always pays to be unique. That much is true for Hidden Survivor, which feels like an odd fusion of classic tag and battle royale. Set in some weird universe where humans turn into ordinary objects, you have to dominate the gym-like battlefield, first by adapting to your environment, and then racing to a revival potion to eliminate the other hidden humans. With pretty short matches, it offers a great casual experience you can jump into anytime. It has a score of an 8.09. At number 4 is Evil Hunter Tycoon, Non-Stop Fighting and Building. Facing you in this title is a twofold task. First, to rebuild a destroyed town back to its former glory, and second, to give brave hunters a space to train their skills for the fight against a Dark Lord. Its city management is enjoyable in itself, with plenty of resources to balance for the betterment of the village. Watch it and your citizens grow from nothingness and save human race once and for all. An interesting pixel title, it receives a play score of an 8.19. We are now approaching the third on our list with Exos Heroes. It's easy to be drawn into Line Games' strategy RPG, especially with its stunning Japanese-style visuals and its roster of characters that's brimming with personality. Just like some of our previous games, it's also a turn-based RPG. What makes this special is its combination of compelling story, solid combat, and awesome presentations. While it still has some of the annoying aspects of standard mobile gacha gaming, it more than makes up for it with its array of colorful heroes. A gorgeous-looking gacha game, it receives a play score of an 8.24. And the second to the best free Android game of 2020 goes to War Tortoise 2 Idle Exploration Shooter. Idle games are just the perfect havens for casual gamers on the smartphone, and maybe that's the reason for the success of this free-to-play first-person shooter. But then again, it's definitely no ordinary idle game. Aside from the fact that it's about a world engulfed in conflict born on the backs of war tortoises, it also mixes up with the elements of exploration and incremental shooting. Featuring gorgeous graphics and a fair money generation system, it earns its spot on this list with a score of an 8.34.
Time for a true display of skill.
And the top free Android game of 2020 goes to Legends of Runeterra. Yes, our best free Android game of 2020 so far is another Riot creation. Their dive into collectible card gaming has been met with nothing but open arms, both by fans already invested in Riot's creations and newbies to the genre. It added its own flavor to card gaming with players competing to destroy the opponent's nexus with dynamic turns, exciting spells, and champions with their upgrades and varying abilities.
They got past me.
Oh, very strong! Fighting is hungry work. You like Boros next?
Add that to the high-quality production that's expected from Riot, and then you got yourself a card game that's fun even when you're losing. It gets a play score of an 8.63. We keep track of all the new games released on the Android and the iOS. For more free-to-play titles, see you next month for another list of the best free Android and iOS games.